Welcome to Out of the Fog. I'm Melissa Royal. Tonight, we have Rosie Myers and James Doyle, two of the organizers from 100 Debates on the Environment for St. John's East. It's a national initiative to have debates on topics related to the environment across the country during the federal election, and there's one happening right here. So we'll speak to the organizers about what they can expect and why the environment is such an important topic in the federal election for this province. Then we'll hear from Prajwala Dixit. She was here last season and spoke with us about her initiative, Diaz for Diversity, that raises money to have a diverse range of books in the children's library. She's here to update us on that project and also what's next for phase two of that initiative. So stay tuned. We'll be right back with those guests. Welcome back to Out of the Fog. I'm here with James Doyle and Rosie Myers, two of the organizers of 100 Debates on the Environment. Welcome to the show.
Thanks for having us.
So this event is coming up real quick, right in the middle of the federal election. Tell us about this debate.
So it's on Thursday. I'll give you the details first, sure. So everybody can hear them right off the bat. It's at 7:30 at the D.F. Cook Recital Hall at Munn. And it's part of a national campaign that GreenPAC put forward. GreenPAC is a nonpartisan, not-for-profit that is working towards electing candidates across party lines who are very strong in the environment. So they have endorsed candidates from all of the main parties. And they've run this campaign called 100 Debates on the Environment. And their aim was to get 100 debates on the same day, October 3rd, across ridings in Canada. And I think they've scheduled 113 is the number they're at now. So in St. John's East and in the Avalon ridings here, we have debates.
And Long Range Mountains.
And Long Range Mountains. Great. So, yeah, I think that Long Range Mountains was the first one scheduled in Newfoundland, and then mm-hmm. we've got Avalon and St. John's East following. And in terms of candidates that we have confirmed so far, we have the Green candidate, David Peters, and the NDP candidate, Jack Harris, and Liberal incumbent, Nick Whelan.
And so what kind of organizations or people are involved in organizing this on a local level? I know it's a national initiative, but there takes bodies on the ground to make it all come together.
Yeah, well, in addition to private volunteers like Rosie or myself, we have the Social Justice Cooperative. It's a group in the province, originally in St. John's, that looks to advance social and economic justice in the province. In this case, ecological justice is their focus now. And they've provided a lot of help, and one of their longstanding members, Dr. Barb Neese, is going to be hosting the debate. As well as them, we have the Departments of Sociology and Political Science, amongst others, at Memorial University. And these will be professors with experience discussing and analyzing the effects of oil and gas on our economy and society and our fishery and these sorts of issues. We also have two groups, Too Big to Ignore, Global Research Partnership and Fishing for Success, a local group looking to get more people in boats and learning about our cultural heritage. That helped craft our questions as well. I've been involved in the offshore fishery a little bit myself, so we have a broad range of partners on the ground to ask questions that are most important to us in Newfoundland and Labrador and in St. John's East specifically.
And so what kind of questions can we look forward to hearing? Not all of them exactly, we don't want to give it all away, but right. certainly it's about the environment, but mm-hmm. are there specific areas you're hoping the conversation directs you in?
Yeah. The biggest question, of course, is what we're going to do globally, also in the country and in Newfoundland and Labrador specifically, about greenhouse gas emissions. They're too high. They're warming our planet. The ocean, to date, has been the punching bag for these greenhouse gas emissions, absorbing about 90% of the heat. And that is the largest question. How are we going to reduce those?